Hi there. It's Professor Monty. We're working with laws of exponents, but as they apply to rational exponents. Okay, so fractional exponents. And the idea is the laws of exponents we've used before work exactly the same. So three of the laws we've seen before, just a quick review. If I have two numbers with the same base and I'm multiplying them, I keep the base and I add the exponents. If I have two numbers with the same base and I'm dividing, I subtract the exponents. And if I have some base raised to a power, and then that whole thing is raised to a power, I keep the base, and I multiply the exponents. Okay, so those are our rules. Let's look at an example of each of those. So 7 to the 1 half times 7 to the 1 third. I have the same base, so I can multiply those together. I keep the base, I add the exponents. Now remember, in order to add exponents, we need a common denominator. So think of the smallest number that 2 and 3 both can go into, which is 6. So I need to build them both up to 6 on the denominator. So I'm going to multiply this one by 3 over 3. I'm going to multiply this one by 2 over 2. And what I end up with is I end up with 7 to the, well, 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 sixths plus 2 sixths. And now I can just add those together, keep the denominator, add the numerators. I get 7 to the 5 sixths. That's as far as I can go. I'm going to leave that there. I could, if I wanted to, I could say, hey, you know what? This is the 6th root of 7 to the 5th. That's true. Did it simplify? Did it help me out? No, there's nothing I can do there. But usually they'll just leave it as 7 to the 5 sixths. But this is an equivalent way to write that same thing. Okay. Now I've got two numbers with the same base. This time I'm dividing, so remember I subtract the exponents. So this is just going to be x to the 3 halves minus 1 half. And then I already have the same denominator, so I'm going to just subtract the numerators. I get x to the 2 fifths. And I'll just leave it like that. That's my answer. And then one last one, it's the power to a power. Remember, I multiply exponents. So I'm essentially going to bring this 2, this is going to be raised to the 2 fifths, this is going to be raised to the 2 fifths, but by multiplying exponents. So it's going to come out as a to the 1 third times 2 fifths, and b to the negative 3 sevenths times 2 fifths. I noticed I said 2 fifths and wrote 5 fifths. But 2 fifths, and then remember I just multiply straight across with my fractions. This is going to be a to the 2 fifteenths. This is going to be b to the negative 6 35ths. And then if you remember, I can't have negative exponents in my answer, so I have to deal with that. Well, that means I'm going to move it to the denominator. Because remember, I take the reciprocal with the negative exponent. So I get a to the 2 fifteenths divided by b to the 6 35ths. All right, and they would just want us to leave it that way. I can't leave negative exponents, so I didn't. But none of that can be simplified, so that's my answer. So the big key to this, the big takeaway, all the same properties of exponents we learned in the past still apply, even if it's fractional or negative exponents.